They have healed the wound of my people lightly, saying, peace, peace, when there is no peace. They were ashamed when they committed the abomination. Reading from our gospel text. When Jesus drew near, he saw the city. He wept over it, saying, would that you, even you, had known on this day the things that make for peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace is one of those things that you either have or you do not have. There is either turmoil or there is not turmoil. Peace in and of itself is something that we as humans ought to strive for. We should and we must pursue peace. When I look out amongst all the members here today, my heart is full. It's full to bursting to see how many of you are here. You're striving for peace. That is the one thing that we need. Peace amongst each and every one of us. But then why is Christ saying here in our text and in our Old Testament text, why then do we claim peace, peace when there is no peace? And again, Christ wept over Jerusalem, saying, would that you, even you, had known this day the things that make for peace. The things that make for peace. These are the things that we must strive for. These are the things that are Christian things. And yet, the Christian church seems to be divided over and over and over again. How many denominations do we have before we realize that we aren't striving for peace? How many more sects do we need? How many more facets do we need? How many more cults that claim the name of Christ yet teach a false god do we need? Christ looked upon Jerusalem, the very place that we find the Israelites, and he weeps. He cries because there's no peace in his land. If that is true, and since that is true, how much more must he weep when our hearts are rent into. When we do not strive for peace, when we do not work with one another, even Christ himself, who desires peace, did the one thing in our gospel text that you don't expect Jesus to do. He became angry. But he became angry and justified in that anger because he was looking for peace. And in the one place where there should be peace, there wasn't. The one place that there should have been peace, there wasn't. It became a den of robbers who sold and made money in the midst of the house of God. Not only that, but there was politics. What does it say in the last part of our gospel text? He was teaching daily in the temple. And the chief priests and the scribes and the principal men of the people were seeking to destroy Jesus. They were seeking to destroy Jesus himself. Who were? Politicians. Scribes. The chief priests and the principal men of the people. So Christ drives out the robbers. He drives out those who would make a mockery in his house, only to find this, that the politics within the temple seek to destroy Jesus himself. And if that is true, then we also must, as we strive for peace, look at our own house, at Augustana Evangelical Lutheran Church, and say, are there politics in the midst of us? If there are politics in the midst of us, and it's in our hearts, we must drive it out as Christ drove out the robbers. We must strive for peace, peace, to where we can say there is peace. There is a great chasm, a great separation between those who quarrel and those who have peace. And the only way that you can get from one to the other is by the cross beams of Jesus' crucifix. It's the only way. The crucifixion of Jesus Christ is the only way that we will have peace. And I don't mean only Augustana Evangelical Lutheran Church, though I do mean it, also in the Christian church. The divisions amongst us in heaven, will we really be seated in different sections? Will some of us have better seats? Well, our confession must be pure, and in that purity, we find this. Jesus came to earth so that we would have peace. What is he called during Advent and Christmas time? The Prince of Peace. And who is a prince? The Son of a King. The Son of God the Father himself. Come down to earth that he would look upon us and say, you who are in turmoil over your sin, have peace. Have the forgiveness that I give unto you. Eat my body, drink my blood, and know this. Simply, and every preacher should preach this, and I forget to say it in these simple words. Christ says, I love you. Simple, isn't it? Because when Christ says, I love you, you be still, and you know that he is God. And when we're still, and we know that God is for us, and we look to God, and we see Jesus Christ, his Son, the Prince of Peace, then we have peace. Forevermore in the kingdom of heaven. Let us strive for peace in the midst of this sanctuary. May we strive for peace in our lives. May we strive for peace in our own hearts. But as we strive, and the Holy Spirit leads us to do good works, not because it saves us, but because we are saved, let us know this, that Jesus Christ gives us exactly what we need. Even turmoil on this earth, he whispers this, I died for you. I love you. What more can I say? Amen. And now may the peace which surpasses all human understanding keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.